Hello, and welcome back to another edition of the MIDIC Trust Plugin. My name is Nathaniel P. Wilkerson, and today I wanted to talk a little bit more about complex roofs and a couple little minor updates I've made to the complex roof module. So first of all, when you go in and draw your complex roof, let's go ahead and do that. And I've gone ahead and created a grid and some faces here just to demonstrate some points, but go ahead and select rafter and so let's just go ahead and throw one down real quick here. Nothing too big. And as you notice, I have to go around and select the points, which isn't too big a deal, but it does take some time. And maybe if you have a face already, you may want to have the ability to use a face. So let's go ahead and demonstrate that. But first, I just want to show you guys, you know, that's the typical drawing process for the complex roof. The other thing too you may have noticed is, well, the one thing is you have a lot of bodies being created, geometry, right? So it's kind of slow. And if you're just kind of roughing things out, maybe you don't want all of that geometry being created. So you do have the option, of course, to turn off some of the framing elements and the sheathing and cladding and what have you, but I've gone a little step further actually, and so I'm going to just go ahead and delete this roof. And basically, let's go back into the draw menu. So you'll notice here under roof framing, I'm going to open this up, and you have roof framing no, which turns off the rafters, but it does not turn off the sheathing and cladding automatically or the subfascia, which of course you can individually turn off down in here in the advanced options, but just for ease of use and quick mocking things up, you can go and select what's called the primitive mode. Okay, so primitive, basically all it essentially draws is just the outline and the hidden here, let's demonstrate that and we'll show you. Okay, you can see obviously it's very fast, so it just it's extremely quick, and it's very lightweight. So that's pretty much the point here. I mean, you get in here and edit this thing, it just quickly jumps up to whatever. So yeah, so basically all you're getting when you use the primitive mode is you're getting the kind of the primitive solid that's created on the hidden layer, this right here. And you're also getting the roof outline, which of course you need in order to edit or move roof edges, right? So just like before, I'll just show you here, you know, if you want to move one of these roof edges, you come in here, it hides the hidden solid for you real quick. And then, of course, once you finish, it actually will hide the outline as well. That's by default. So anyways, that's a new feature. And also, you know, for people that are wanting that to be that behavior to be default, I have actually added in here in the global settings, I've got a new tab called Complex Roofs. And here you can actually set the roof framing mode. So I'm going to go ahead and just set that to primitive for now. And you can also set the advanced options. And I've got a bunch more stuff that I need to add in here. But this is kind of a start, right? So yeah, at least you've got that. So you can go ahead and set your default behavior, whether it's turn all the framing on or turn it all off in the primitive mode. It's whatever you like. Okay, so now let's go ahead and take a look at these faces. So up until now, if you go ahead and draw a roof, you know, you got to go point by point, picking your points, this sort of thing. Okay. And it's quite tedious. So and what I've done is there's an up arrow here. So if you hit the up arrow, and you can start, you know, off by clicking a bunch of points, but if you hit the up arrow, all those points will go away. And now if you mouse over top of these faces, it will, you can select the face. So then you just go ahead and click that face and boom, you've got yourself a roof. So just a slightly quicker way of drawing the roofs. You know, you can do it point by point or you can do it. So I'm going to go right here. And also, when this first loads, you'll notice that the menu is highlighted. That's the focus. What you want to do is you want to make sure your focus is, and notice how that grayed out now, the focus is the main window. Once it's the main window, then you can go ahead and hit that up arrow. And notice down here in the menu, you can see it says select face for roof footprint. And then if you hit it again, it actually goes back to click first corner of polygon. So you can toggle back and forth between the point by point, or you can toggle just by clicking that to the face. So I'll go ahead and click that. And there's your roof. And then of course these roofs are no different than any others. If you want to edit that roof, you can get in here and do that sort of thing. But I do like the fact of having this primitive option, just because I think it's nice to be able to get in here. And you know, this is giving you your true roof planes. There's no sheathing or cladding, you know, sitting on top of that. That is your roof planes. So, you know, for your first conceptual look at something, I think that's kind of handy to have. And it's very speedy. It's not heavily loaded up with, you know, different rafter elements and such. So it's very responsive. Anyways, yeah, so three things here. We have the option to do a face to create the geometry. We have added the primitive option in the roof framing mode. I guess that's the right word, roof framing, yes. Primitive option, now you have three. Well, yes, no, and primitive. And then we've also added just a couple of and parameters here in the global settings under complex roofs, which is a new tab. All right, well, thank you very much. And if you guys have any questions about this new feature, please feel free to reach out to me. All right, thanks.